For this episode of the AI Show, I thought we would take a look at the Global AI Nights keynote I got to do with Eric Boyd, Corporate Vice President of Azure AI. We filmed it earlier. Hope you like it. Thank you so much for that wonderful introduction, Amy and Hank. I have the privilege of having with me here Eric Boyd, Corporate Vice President of Azure AI. How you doing, my friend?
I'm doing great. Good to see you again, Seth.
Fantastic. Everything going well?
Always. Always going well.
Fantastic. So here's a question that I want to start with that I think is important. What is interesting in Azure AI for both data scientists and developers? What do you think?
One of the things we've really focused on is making Azure AI really easy to use regardless of where you are in your AI journey. And so if you're really beginning as a developer in AI and starting out, you can get started immediately with things like cognitive services that let you just directly pull really powerful algorithms into your application without having to go through all the steps of training and everything. On the other hand, if you're becoming more sophisticated or starting to train your own models, you can use the AML Azure Machine Learning platform to go ahead and train your own models using, you know, things like automated machine learning, which will really take all the work out of for you. You can use our new drag and drop interface, which makes it really simple to create models. Or, you know, for more experienced and sophisticated data scientists, we have really powerful tools integrating with Jupyter Networks and hyperparameter tuning. We really bring it all in one package and really focus on making it easy for you to use and get started and get going with it.
Fantastic. And so here's a question, and because we have you here and everyone's watching, hopefully, can you give us an interesting story, maybe a behind-the-scenes look at a product
Sure.
that we've built? What makes it interesting?
I mean, you know, one interesting story, a lot of our products really come from the research team. And so we work closely with MSR to sort of see what are the newest and most interesting things they've developed. You know, one of our researchers in MSR, Nicola Fusi, he was working on, you know, predicting where we should be doing CRISPR gene editing. And so he built a machine learning model to try and figure out among the 18 billion different places you can sort of cut and splice these genes, what are going to be some of the best places for it. And he really found himself getting frustrated with the amount of time he was spending doing all the hyperparameter tuning and sort of selecting through all these models. And so he wrote a system that would sort of recommend what was the best model for him to use. And as he was sort of using that, he realized, boy, this is really useful. And so, you know, further developed it and showed it off at a hackathon. We did a SLT review with Satya and his team and sort of showed off, hey, this is the capability that could exist. And then my team worked very closely with Nicolo and his team in MSR to really turn that into the automated machine learning product. And so, you know, really just working with the research team to see what are the groundbreaking things that they're doing, often in a field that's completely unrelated to the tool that we actually end up developing. You know, we have several sort of iterations like that. And so it's really great to have that partnership with MSR and to really bring these innovations to life for all of our customers.
For those that are just hearing about automated ML, why don't you explain what it is so people can get a sense for how powerful it actually is?
Well, it's exactly what Nicola was trying to do is, you know, he needed to create lots and lots of models. And it's fairly tedious to go and create these models. There's this process of I have some data and I pick, you know, which of my different algorithms do I want to try, and then I have a whole bunch of hyperparameters that I need to tune, things like the learning rate. And you know, by just automating that process, it did two things. One is for an experienced machine learning expert like Nicolo, it's just saved him a ton of time. Right. You know, you can very quickly learn these are the parameters that are likely going to work, these are the algorithms, this data actually is learnable, you have the right signals in there. And so he can become much more productive. But the other thing that it did is because it's recommending a machine learning algorithm, it really opens machine learning up to people who don't have the background and expertise in it. And so we've taken automated machine learning and we've built a user interface on top of it where now all you need to do is say, I want to predict home prices. Here's my data set of all the home prices, and this is the column I want to predict. Give me the best model that you can. And, you know, we often get some skepticism from people. I'm like, yeah, but it's not any good, right? It works really well. We've taken it to a lot of internal teams. We routinely say match the performance of their data scientists because we don't want anyone to feel bad.
Right.
You know, we even have entered it into some contests, you know, machine learning contests. And we're typically, you know, we've gotten top 5% performances regularly. And so you can probably do better if you're a data scientist hand tuning it yourself. but for effectively zero effort to get a top 5% model is really great.
I always suggest you should literally just start with automate on a new problem, Greenfield, just start with automated ML, and then at least you'll know where to start looking.
You'll know if it's learnable, you'll know the types of things you can do, and often that's all you need to do. We have a lot of customers that you know, they're using that, and you can do it at scale to build hundreds of models that would take you hours to put together by yourself.
That's cool. So we talked about automated ML. That's something that's been in the product for a
yes.
little bit. What's new in Azure AI that people should really take a look at?
You know, we had a lot of things that we just announced at Build that are really, you know, taking the product to a new level. You know, on the platform side, really focusing on the simplicity and on the operations, the ML ops side of it. But one of the new services I'm really excited about is Personalizer. And so this is a service that you know, we'll recommend based on, you know, each individual user's unique attributes, you know, the things that you like to do and what you're interested in, what content is going to be most relevant for you. And, you know, there are a lot of personalization systems out there. This isn't a new idea. But what's new about what we've done is this is based on a reinforcement learning system. And so that really has made this, you know, much more powerful.
For those that are getting into machine learning, what is reinforcement learning?
Sure. So the idea with reinforcement learning, you know, in a traditional machine learning model, you take a massive data set of, you know, hey, here are all the interactions people had on my website and which users clicked on which thing, and you train a model to predict on that. Reinforcement learning kind of turns it on its head. And so it basically, it will guess what's going to be the content that's going to be best for a user like you, and it'll learn from your responses and sort of reinforce the model as it goes. And the thing that's really powerful about that is, you know, for sites like, we use this in MSN, and so there are new news articles coming out all the time. And so we can't train a new model based on the historical performance of a new news article, but reinforcement learning will learn as it goes, and so it will experiment, it will try, and then it will say, oh, this is going to be the content that works best. And so by using reinforcement learning in that model, it's, you don't have to train it, you set it up, you let it go, it performs really, really well. And so that's something we've been very excited about.
Is this being used anywhere?
Yeah, so I mean, I talked about, we use it internally at MSN, we also use it in Xbox. And then, you know, there are customers, you know, the Women's Tennis Association has recently deployed this on their website, and maybe I can show an example of that. So, this is a mock-up of the Women's Tennis Association site. And you know, the idea is it sort of looks like your MSN page where you have here, you know, the main article and then a number of other articles they could have selected from. And you know, if we click to sort of see how it works under the covers, you can see what we did is in the request we sent just some features on what are the things that we know about this user. And you know, since this is a demo case, there aren't a lot of features,
right. But
this is where you would put what, you know, the history, the things that they'd done in the past, and then you send that in, and then down at the bottom of the page, you get a response that says, all right, what's the thing that the article that we should show? And then if I click into this particular article, again, the thing that you see is we've got this engagement reward up at the top. And so that's one of the key things with reinforcement learning is you need to tell the algorithm, was this good or not? Did the user do something that we liked or not? So we give a reward, and in this case, the reward is simply how far down the page did they scroll?
Oh, that's cool.
And so as I scroll further down the page, we're saying, oh, they did a better and better job. And so that then tells this user, oh, they read this whole article. This one's really relevant for this type of user, which goes back into the reinforcement learning algorithm and makes it better and better over time.
And this is something that the user does not have to write. It's just a service that they call.
You just, you know, it's a couple of lines to sort of make the call out there, and then everything else, you know, this model will go and learn on its own. And, you know, we've had a lot of customers that have been replacing their existing, you know, as I say, personalization is not new, and they're seeing substantial improvements over the existing systems, really because reinforcement learning is a really powerful tool to have underneath of it.
That's awesome. So where can people go to get started? Because this is all cool stuff, but sometimes it feels like it's way over here, over my head. Where can I go to get started?
So that's a great question. We've just put together a new Getting Started with Azure Machine Learning page. And you know, on there, you can see lots of examples and interact with them directly in notebooks and try things out and really experiment and learn with all the tutorials and all the material that we've put together to really help get you ramped up on machine learning.
Awesome. Any final thoughts?
I think we're really excited about the things that we've developed and, really glad that everyone has come. I want to thank the organizers and all the participants. I think this is going to be a great session for you guys, so really looking forward to it.
Fantastic. Well, thanks so much for spending some time with us. Thanks so much for watching this portion of the keynote. We're going to toss it back to Amy and Hank, who have some additional information. Hope you enjoyed that as much as I did. If you want to learn more about Global AI Nights, go to global.ainights.com to learn about an event near you. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.